Welcome to Phoenix Medical Lectures. In today's video, we will be seeing the physiology of endocrine pancreas part 2. The first thing we're going to see is glucagon. So the sources of glucagon, first is the alpha cells of the islet of Langerhans of the endocrine pancreas and the wall of the GIT, specifically the stomach and the duodenum. The glucagon contains 29 amino acids. So coming to the synthesis and secretion of glucagon, glucagon is first synthesized as pre-proglucagon, which is then converted into proglucagon, and finally by exocytosis it is released as glucagon. So glucagon is normally transported in free form in the blood, and the half-life of glucagon is 5 to 10 minutes. So now coming to the physiological action of glucagon. First we will see its effect on the carbohydrate metabolism. So normally the difference between insulin and glucagon is that insulin tends to lower the blood sugar level, whereas glucagon tends to increase the blood sugar level. So its effect on carbohydrate metabolism depends on that. So as we saw in the previous video, insulin tends to promote glycogenesis, and it normally tends to inhibit glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. So the reason behind this is that insulin has to lower the blood sugar level. So coming to glucagon, it has to be the exact opposite of what insulin does. So glucagon tends to promote glycogenolysis and also promote gluconeogenesis, whereas it inhibits glycogenesis. So now coming to the lipid metabolism. Again, like the carbohydrate metabolism, the effect of glucagon on lipid metabolism is the exact opposite of the effect of insulin on lipid metabolism. So as we saw in the previous video, insulin tends to inhibit lipases, thereby decreasing lipolysis, which causes reduced free fatty acid levels in the blood. So the glucagon's effect on lipid metabolism is that it increases the lipases, it stimulates lipases, thereby increasing lipolysis, which leads to increased free fatty acid levels in the blood. So what happens is that, as we already saw, when there is an increased free fatty acid level in the blood, it tends to get converted into ketone bodies. Therefore, in this case as well, glucagon causes an increased free fatty acid level in the blood. So this is ketogenic. So the effect of glucagon in protein metabolism is that it destructs the protein and converts it into glucose. So now coming to the action of glucagon on hormones. So it tends to stimulate the growth hormone, insulin secretion, as well as somatostatin secretion. Now we'll see the effect of glucagon on the heart. So when there is an exogenous administration of glucagon, it exerts a positive inotrophic effect. So a positive inotrophic effect means there is an enhancement in the contraction of the cardiac muscles. So this is not mediated by the beta receptors. Rather, it is mediated via cyclic AMP. So this is preferred and recommended as a treatment for a beta adrenal toxicity. So the positive ionotropic effect is mediated by cyclic AMP and it is recommended as a treatment for beta blocker toxicity. And it also accelerates the AV conduction. So now we'll see the regulation of glucagon secretion. On one side we have all that which promotes glucagon secretion, and on the other side we have all that which inhibits the glucagon secretion. First, we'll see the blood glucose level. So when there is a low level of blood glucose, it tends to stimulate the glucagon secretion. And hormones, GI hormones like CCK and gastrin also stimulate glucagon secretion. And when there is an increased level of amino acid, it also tends to promote glucagon secretion. On the other hand, when there is a high level of blood glucose, it tends to inhibit glucagon secretion, and GI hormones like secretin and somatostatin also inhibit glucagon secretion, and insulin inhibits glucagon secretion. Now we will see the insulin glucagon ratio. More than its individual concentration, the ratio of insulin and glucagon is important. First, we will see the insulin glucagon ratio in fed state. So in fed state, the insulin glucagon ratio is 2. So insulin dominates this state, and the overall reaction is that the body undergoes net anabolism. Anabolism is the formation of complex molecules from simple ones. So all the glucose that is ingested will go for energy production, and all the excess glucose that is present will be stored as glycogen or fat, and all the amino acids are primarily utilized for protein synthesis. So now we'll see in the fasting state. In the fasting state, the ratio will decrease to 1. So in this phase, glucagon predominates. In cases of prolonged fasting, this might even go down to 0.4. So what happens during this state is that the glucose is released from glycogen and it enters the bloodstream in order to prevent hypoglycemia.